without any further ado, as Chris might say.
Ball gone.
Welcome to the ULI Podcast, the podcast dedicated to calling out your friends' bullshit. I'm Brian.
This is Chris.
Your main man, Maury.
Favorite podcast, Sir D's. Mixed major in the house.
In the house!
Mixed major!
Boy. Yeah, you see,
we've been trying to get this dude in here for a minute, to be real with you.
Yeah, man.
The legendary.
He's elusive.
One, and one, one of a kind.
That's a Kipson.
You spotted a wild.
Oh, man. But this is one of the best sound engineers
in the town.
Yeah, for sure. Blessing us with his presence tonight. About to make a ULI debut. So if you don't know, make sure you follow our brother. What's your handle? Put your handle in here while we got you.
Yeah, we're going to drop it.
Oh, shoot, I have so many.
Yeah. Go ahead. Take your time. We're going to do it in the outro, too.
We should have prepped it.
It's fine.
Follow me at Mixed Major Dre 23 on Instagram.
There you go.
On Snapchat. You can hit me at DJ Mix Major. I'm also a DJ as well, so if you need any parties done.
Come on. You see the black entrepreneurship happening at the table.
We're going to plug again at the end. We always plug at the end.
We always do. But like any other week, we are here ready to kick that shit, ready to have a good time and tight situations, but we're going to get it in anyway. You feel me? We got shots to deliver. Oh, there it is.
Oh, that's right. All right,
y'all got shots.
Hold on. I mean, first priority is
priorities.
The Raiders finally lost, as we all knew they would inevitably do.
What's priority?
Because I've been doubling down for like 4 episodes.
You did.
Because I knew.
And he took 3 shots previously.
And that's the only reason I was mad chance. They lost.
It's a numbers game, man.
I ain't going to be like, take the shot.
Take the goddamn shot. But before y'all do that, I'm going to join you. Because shout out to Kata Money Jones.
Uh-huh.
We see you. I might have spewed some bullshit last episode that may or may not have been true about mid-range jumpers and championship teams. So I'm going to vaguely skip over that.
We love somebody the fact checkers, though. We love the fact checkers.
Appreciate the fact check.
This nigga was fact checked.
Niggas be talking about mid-range stats.
I'd have called that shit out though too.
I called that on the show.
I'd have called that.
So I would like to personally
respect.
I would personally like to dedicate this toast to Kata Money Jones, and I would like to say to you, you can kiss my ass. All right, you can kiss my
Kata.
You can kiss my pale black ass.
Go ahead, Kata.
However that works. All right.
All right, for the continuity.
For the continuity, because
when we do get caught up.
In the Raiders.
Up in that BS.
Believe in the Raiders.
Yeah, we already know, if you've been watching the show, and if you don't know, it get hit with punishments. Those punishments include the shot that you see us all about to partake in that lost these bets. Maury lost some money, too.
I lost some money betting on them weird-ass food.
Straight bums. Maury not coming out of this clean
straight
either.
Straight bums, homie.
Hey, y'all,
I said, Chris, man, what should I go to? Yeah, they go to Raiders, man.
Come on.
How much, Maury?
Pull through for your boy right here. So I can have a little bit of respect when I return to work. Come on, man. Come on. Pull through with this win.
Facts.
These raggy ass Bears. You feel me? So we got to get Justin Fields up out of here.
They 2-2.
All right, man.
Yeah, they all right.
Anyway.
Oh, but penalties.
To continuity.
The shot, what you about to take.
Yeah.
The $10 cash app. And the stay ready push-ups. But for continuity.
I was thinking about a cruise, y'all. What y'all think about a cruise? Oh, we got to get vaccinated.
Let's fucking do it.
We got to get vaccinated.
Sure do.
Yeah, that's true.
Well, I'm
like, it'll be me and Brian. Come on, nigga.
Yeah. There you go.
Come on, nigga.
He done sold out and joined the clan.
Sold out, man. Damn, man. I feel like Andrew Wiggins. Sign of the beast.
Andrew Wiggins.
I got the first shot.
Okay.
He got time to back out. You know, you got to get the booster, too.
I ain't getting no booster.
You got to get the booster.
But we did. We wrapped that up, right?
Let's get into it.
All right, I'll bring it in. So for my subject, y'all know it's been a hot topic because your boy is the GOAT, Mr. Dave Chappelle. Oh,
okay.
Did his, what he calls his, what's
the closer?
The closer. And he started it by saying, like, this is the last stand-up he was going to do
For Netflix.
This is it. This is the closer. This is the end. So, when he said that, I already was expecting him to go in. You feel me? I was expecting him to bring the heat.
Bring some heat.
I was expecting it.
Get ready for some heat.
But he's facing backlash.
He does all the time.
Like he does all the time from a lot of the LGBTQ community.
Yes. All of them.
More specifically, the trans community.
Almost as if they provoked him to do it.
He knew what he was doing. Okay.
Well, I mean, I'm not saying that he didn't know what he was doing, but you make it so easy.
So mainly from them saying, claiming he's transphobic and spreading trans hate through his stand up and use his platform to say, most of those people that I've come across or that I've witnessed have not even watched the stand up, so they don't know. What he did was kept consistent with his whole delivery.
Right.
But he did touch on some shit. And after, if you watch the whole thing, you will not walk away from that feeling like he's any phobic. Not, maybe except for white phobic.
Although he did call himself transphobic like four times.
But he did it in a, he did it sarcastically.
Yeah. No, I'm being facetious.
Okay,
But still.
So there was people trying to get him canceled. There's this national
he got backlash.
National Black Justice Coalition that's supposed to be defending of the LGBTQ rights and all this stuff, trying to get Netflix to take his specials down and all this stuff.
That's one of their highest rated shit, but go ahead.
No, it really is. Mind you, this is a nigga who's definitely not in it for the money. And Netflix have already seen
every, it. Every time it drops. Yeah. He dropped like, what, 3-4 of them motherfuckers? Every time
Netflix?
On Netflix.
Right now, it's like the third or fourth most viewed thing on Netflix.
How many drops on Netflix?
Like 3 or 4.
No. Ooh, it's 5.
Is it 3 or 4?
It's 5.
Oh, goddamn.
He dropped 5 on Amazon?
Netflix? It's 5. I want to say 6, but I'm going to stay at 5.
What's happening then?
It's 5.
Man. What's happening?
5 specials. This nigga done dropped like 5.
You don't know.
How many?
He didn't drop 5. He said 6 or 5. What'd you say?
I read it today.
Default.
It wasn't more than 4.
It was more than 4?
That's all I'm saying.
Falls my max.
Nigga, I called it out. One shot.
You saying what?
No, you ain't going to orchestrate. What?
No, you ain't orchestrating shit. What's up?
You ain't going to orchestrate.
No, he dropped 3.
Okay.
You gonna lose.
Nigga, you losing for sure. So, Maury's out.
Wait, 3.
I'm saying 5. It might be 6. It's not 4.
Netflix.
It's 5. It might be 6.
He dropped 4.
What you want? What you want? Caller of the You Alive.
You know what I said? Yeah, I know. I think he got 5 in there.
Oh, now you got 5?
I said 3.
Brian said it and he stood on it. I just
confirmed. Brian, what you said? 5 or 6?
There we go. There we go.
What did you say?
I said 5. I didn't say 6.
Hold on.
You said 5 or 6.
I said from the beginning I was going to stick with 5.
Yeah, what you want? He said that.
What do I want? I want Maury to take a shot. That's all I want. I don't care about nobody else around here.
You're the only one that didn't take
a shot. You asked me what I wanted? That's my wish right now.
I was included in that, though.
Yeah,
you said what?
You were not included. You can't take a shot if you want to, if you have any honor.
You have any honor, you would take a shot.
Hold on, no. Yes, he
would.
Chris stood on that, too.
Yeah, he definitely did.
The number of,
he really did. I think he said 4.
He did. I tried to take it, too.
Strong for it.
Yeah, he tried. Not today. No, we man up to our bullshit here.
That's the tagline.
I suppose.
Somebody don't do that, though.
We'll save that card for later, Brian, when it's needed. When he can't take no more shots, then we'll give him that.
Oh, my God.
Ooh, y'all got to start saying push-ups, my nigga. I've been working out. I can do that.
How many shots have you taken?
Yeah, all of a sudden, niggas want to do the easy shit.
That's easy? Nigga, you do 20 push-ups.
I did last time. I had to do 20 push-ups last episode.
You did.
There's 20 push-ups that I didn't even know I did. I was like, man, I managed to do that for y'all. I'm glad.
Well, that's all. Help out like a motherfucker, though.
For the continuity.
Continuity. Fine, let's go.
Oh, wait.
Anyway, Dave Chappelle.
While he takes this shot.
Dave Chappelle has been making Netflix a lot of money to the point where he had niggas boycott his Dave Chappelle show, and Netflix still stuck with this nigga when everybody was like, how you gonna keep, you know, his stuff on there and all this? So they know what's up. Mm-hmm. So y'all trying to get them to cancel him, that's not gonna happen. It's just not gonna happen. He's already proved that it's not about the money and that his fan base will back his ass. Yeah. And we are supporting him, because if you watch it, you won't walk away with that mentality. People that didn't watch it, seeing a clip,
they were looking for something.
Or seeing a post,
they were looking for something.
Reacting off of that shit.
What you just said is a great example because I just watched it last night. Mm-hmm. To the fact that when you said it's not about the money, he said that I walked away from $50 million.
$50 million, credibility,
straight up,
instant.
I walked away from that shit.
Yeah,
one of the only niggas,
biggest that money at that point
of
in
our
his
generation
life,
that did
biggest
that
money that anybody could be walking away from $50 million for any reason.
Niggas wasn't doing that. Niggas wasn't doing that.
Right.
Everybody thought he was crazy.
Not everybody. I didn't think he was crazy.
Except Sherman, of course. He's the outlier.
No, I didn't think this nigga was crazy.
He's the outlier.
I respected him, nigga.
Mm-hmm. I knew it was something more, like way much more than what was going on. If a man walked away from $50 million,
there's reasons behind
there's a
it.
Bottom line mm-hmm. to that.
Like, yeah.
I found myself putting myself in his shoes.
$50 million.
$50 million, bro.
Like, that generation of wealth.
Man,
yeah, but then you don't get. So that's what it would cost for you to sell your likeness then.
Exactly.
Sell your soul to the devil.
Exactly.
I looked at it like at a certain point, he looked at what he was doing and it was so far from what he wanted.
Yeah.
That if he did that, he'd be going along with like a charade, like a caricature of his life. Yeah.
He wouldn't even be the person
so
that he
I would respect that.
Thought he was at
that's
all.
That's some shit I would hope that I would do in that situation.
Right.
$50 million is a lot of money in your face, and I'm a nigga that's in poverty. I'm just going to be $100. I'm going to be $1 with you.
Okay, I'll take the $50 million.
That's 50 meals. That's 50 whole meals. That's whole meals. But he's still out here on his edge with what he's willing to say. Because that transgender, I don't want to say agenda, but agenda, for lack of better words. For lack of better words, like that agenda is, I think, is a thing. And it's hard.
It's obvious.
I'm dealing with that
shit. It's not just transgender.
In my profession right now, without going into a whole detail, but having to make your brain call someone who isn't.
That.
Listen.
Even though, because right now you wear a mask.
I've told y'all this before.
Right now, hold on. Let me land. Let me land.
Just start out.
Go ahead. Right now we wear a mask, and you only really see the eyes and hair and forehead and all that stuff. So when I'm getting these looks, I see female, and the identification is male, right? So if I'm saying she over here or she did this or oh what's her name or whatever I'm saying with the female pronoun attached is offensive, right? So I'm having to navigate that right now, and that's unnatural. I'll be 100. It's unnatural. Yeah. It's not.
But
it don't seem
example,
right.
Like you said, as what he said on the special, pronouns and these nouns are basically above us. We have to change our own language. We was brought up on and taught
scientifically
to go someone else's way. I understand. We don't want to.
And I don't want to. I'm not intentionally trying to.
Intentionally trying to, but it's like, why do I have to change my vocabulary?
Yeah.
Like he said.
Yeah.
It's unnatural.
Yeah, just for you.
Just for you. Right.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
It feels unnatural. This is the first time I've had to deal with it.
Yeah, still that for sure. Yeah.
So, what this nigga say?
Yeah, get it out. Come on now. Come on now.
The pronoun.
What, the special?
Yeah. See, Dave Chappelle's not stupid. He understands pronouns and the application of them.
He's
and
very
that's
smart.
Why his
he
jokes
thinks,
are so
he
smart.
He very long on
bro, it's the same.
So when this nigga said, he was talking about the pronouns, and he was talking about, he said, there's somebody came up to me in a club, and they was like, hey, Dave, they after you, man. Watch out. Yeah, he said, which day?
One day
or many days.
That was funny.
He knows.
I was like, wow.
Like, I might be able to handle myself, or I might not. I got any clarification.
Okay, but do you feel like what he said when he was talking about his friend that was a transgender and was a comedian, do you feel like what he said was took from that community as well as we took it?
No. Except
being outside of
it. Didn't get to that. Because they didn't watch it.
Yeah,
so
no, they definitely didn't
and
watch the whole
point
special.
That he made with that, which was like as much as he was still being Dave and making his jokes. Yeah, I think that's.
I would think 95% of the trans community when they watched the special, it was a hate watch. It wasn't.
I don't think they made it that far.
He did make a point to be anti, right? To be aggressive on his point that y'all ain't gonna be able to tell me what to say.
I think he didn't blunt his words, but I don't think he was anti at all.
No, exactly.
He was anti. I can't
you don't gotta
say,
be sensitive.
I can't say. I can say whatever I want to say is what he was basically where he was.
And where I seen that, I didn't see the special, but I seen a little clip that I'm like, man, that, yeah, he true. The baby,
killed a nigga in Walmart.
He said that.
Killed a nigga in Walmart.
What we talked about months ago.
Killed a nigga in Walmart and didn't get no backlash or his career.
He was a real nigga at that point.
Yeah. Because he killed a nigga.
But
it was taken out of so much context.
It was taken out of context.
It was a reasonable reason.
But it was absolutely true.
But the baby says this about the LGBTQ now. We got to apologize for saying this and that, but he just killed a whole ass nigga and his
career. Nobody got a problem with that.
But we got to worry about their feelings and how they feel on.
It's not that people don't even have a problem with it. It's to his credit that he killed somebody at Walmart.
It's to his credit. You're right.
Because he killed another black man.
He got away from stuff.
That's fine.
He got off on it.
That's fine.
Family.
He was
fine. But as it is perceived by the public,
he was.
Yeah, as it is perceived by the public, he's kind of venerated a little bit for being willing to kill somebody.
Right. But
what does venerated mean?
I think that means like celebrated.
Because he just brought it out the fact that it's.
I might have said that wrong.
I agree with that.
Or transgender person that has HIV. I understand.
Go ahead, Maury. What's up? What's up, man? You gonna take my vocab? We gonna have the world's first vocab. You alive? I know I can't see your eyes behind them glasses, but I see. Venerated.
Venerated means what?
Venerated.
What's that mean?
Ah, fuck, man. I don't know. I just said it like.
You said it means like celebrated, right? Venerated.
You know, I got it right there. What are we doing?
Okay, so.
You a goddamn liar. What do you mean?
That lose.
What you want? Before we even use.
It
sounds like Maury won this one.
Cash App.
He wants $10.
I'm broke.
He said he needs something. He's trying to get some asparagus from the produce guy.
I need some soap.
He called it out. I have no say.
Let's look at it first.
Yeah, look at it first.
He wants $10. What were you saying?
That was for my personal drink.
Oh, my fault. Wait, hold on. Denise should appreciate
it. I need a drink for this.
What does venerated mean?
He said celebration. I say it don't mean celebrated.
To be celebrated.
That's what it means?
You know, I'm going to stick with that.
Oh, to be celebrated?
Yeah, that's what it is.
I'm going to stick with it.
Using a sentence.
What are you going to read, Chris?
To regard with great respect. Revere. Right.
Basically.
That's celebrated?
The same one we got out here.
Is that celebrated?
I will accept celebrated.
It would say celebrated in the definition?
It doesn't say
celebrated. Okay, then.
It doesn't say the word.
Yeah, what you got?
Ooh.
Can we get a vote?
I move to vote.
Let me say it again.
Celebrate with great respect. Or revere?
Revere.
You don't celebrate things you revere?
Celebrate not in that definition.
No. Maury's playing the words matter game, and I feel him on that. So look it up. See if there is a synonym for all of that includes celebrated.
Right.
Because you can look it up in a
They would say celebrated. They would say celebrated.
A synonym.
So it has to be a synonym now?
Let me see.
Well, for it to mean the same thing.
I feel like it should work.
All right.
I don't think you got much to sweat on here on this one.
Right. Well, I feel like I used that word correctly, but you know. So what happens when you have a deep vocab?
I've never even heard that word.
Me either. He's trying to say it. He's trying to say
it. I'm drunk, man. I was just trying to find words.
I can't remember.
Yeah, I'm reaching.
But Brian, to that point, like you were saying, like he can shoot a nigga basically.
Exactly.
Right, so here are
synonyms. That's my point.
Here are synonyms.
But do you feel like it's different because he's a gangster rapper or a rapper?
Daquan! My nigga.
Yes.
Who's a gangster rapper?
Hold on, it's fine. Let's run with it. We about to run this out. We about to wrap up the July, which I'm about to win.
Let me get a synonym.
DeAndre's making a real good point.
Let me get synonyms real quick. We got adore.
Okay.
Reverence. Revere. Worship. Honor. Admire.
Oh. You celebrate in there?
Nope. Come on, like.
Celebrate not in there. That is celebrate.
Y'all look at me right now. Everybody.
It wasn't on there.
Are we just petty? It wasn't on there.
No. We about to establish a level of pettiness right now.
I'm on my nigga. I'm on Brian's side.
Let's establish right now.
What are we doing?
Are we going to do this? Because I will be real petty. I will
be real petty.
I'm over here.
Y'all want to get brutal?
Sherman, what you thinking?
Don't do this.
That list of words, a lot of those were synonyms for celebrated, though.
Come on. Nigga, them words was like celebrated times five.
Basically.
They didn't say celebrated, though. Okay.
Brian needs $10.
But that's if you look up any
listen.
Other words,
no, that's $10.
I will pay this $10 right now.
Damn it.
You can put some bullshit.
You know what? That's a year.
I'll pay this $10 right now. Some bullshit.
I'll give it that. I was trying.
I'll give it that.
But we all know.
He can put it in 805, okay? Right? He can put it in 805.
I give it that. We ain't going to trip our way through this bullshit, right? Did everybody hear the synonyms?
Things you say are
did everybody hear the words?
Hey, what's his name? Kata?
My name. Kata, back me up on this one, brother. Don't back him up. Just go. Do it.
He wrong, Kata.
Shame on me.
My nigga. Yeah.
Anyway. Where's my glasses?
So,
anyway.
My nigga Brian needs $10. That's all I'm saying.
I give him $10.
All I'm saying is pay me.
Put it in the 805.
Okay. Yeah,
he gonna put it in the 805.
Okay, now that that's been resolved, let's get back to this nigga DeAndre's point.
As we wrap it.
You venerated my ass.
No, actually, let him say it because I wanted to start it over because he was talking. Yeah, what was he saying?
Do you feel that whatever his purpose or stance on that is getting taken differently because he's a rapper?
Oh, absolutely. Well, yes. With rappers, there's a stigma. There's all kinds of shit that come with it. Just like basketball players, just like anything with like black culture,
right.
Like you expect a certain type of attitude, you expect a certain type of demeanor. So you accept that this dude shot another black dude. We all did actually, without thinking about it, because it happens so often.
Hey, he tried you with your daughter there. Blast that nigga! Oh God, I'm with too.
But we would have thought that about any race. That's the problem.
No, it's also with
black people. We would have thought that we would have thought that was fair. That's in any situation, right?
Agreed.
All of us.
Agreed.
But in different races, my thought felt
otherwise,
differently.
Otherwise, I don't care about that.
But but the problem is, I think Dave pointed out that he did kill another black man and nobody made a fuss about it. He got away with it, and it was to his credit.
And then he said some words on stage.
I
don't have anything personally against the baby.
How many festivals did they take from this nigga in summertime?
That's my next one because that's taking money out of his family.
Come on.
At the end of the day, he said...
I swear, they was yanking him from this thing.
He said that, which was a mistake he apologized for, but not to beat Dave down, but Dave said so much more about transgender. He's getting
directly.
I feel like it's that is different because it is a truly personal battle between them. I think there's a grudge there that has been acknowledged by Dave and is not being acknowledged by the transgender community.
Exactly.
They're not saying we went here and we tried to smear his name through the mud and it didn't work. They're not saying that. They just won't give up.
But check this out.
Smear Dave.
Check this out. Check this out.
You can't. That's the problem. You can have an honest dialogue with them and you might get further.
Yes, because he's so brilliant when it comes to that stand-up shit. And I think anybody that watches stand-up knows how hard that art is.
How tough it is to woo a crowd for an hour
talking on stage with a mic. No, that's it. No fireworks, no dancers, no screams.
It's just you up there.
No, it's just you.
It's just you and us.
And yet you're the only comedian in the world who knows. Man, maybe not the only one. Maybe one of the only few.
Can I make his last point? Can I ask this? Does it seem like the last special was even as special? Does it feel like it was
a
conversation?
Nigga, he said he was gonna be, he basically told all of us he was gonna be laying low for a minute after this special. Stand-up? Do you not remember that? I was like, oh, this is gonna be good.
Stand-up wise,
he said, this is
I
gonna be my
like
last
it,
special
like,
for
as
a
much
minute.
As I liked his other ones.
Exactly.
Stand-up wise.
I liked it.
Stand-up wise.
I feel like he set the precedence for what I think stand-up should be.
He gave examples.
And that particular one?
Yeah.
I think Six of Stones was better.
Six of Stones was better to me, too.
Yeah. Damn.
I want to make 2 points. I want to make two points before we end this.
Right.
I want to make 2 points.
Okay.
One thing. First thing. I know a lot of people didn't watch shit. Did you watch shit? What did he say? His problem is with white people.
That camera
not
don't
trans
work.
People.
That camera, that camera not on.
It's white people, not trans people.
That camera not on either.
This one's on, right?
So.
This one on, too.
If you watch it, you won't walk away with that thought. The second thing is, if you really pay attention to what he's saying, he even said at the end, I'm actually jealous of y'all community because of the progress that y'all have been able to make in our society that black folks have been trying to get to
for years.
Centuries.
Centuries. Come on.
Centuries.
right, man, my topic is Kyrie Irving, the Brooklyn Nets star point guard. He's they got a big three. They got Kevin Durant.
Star point guard?
Bro, he's a star point guard. He's a fucking...
I'm just playing.
Star point guard. No, go ahead. What you got to say?
No, I'm just...
Star point. You got KD, you got James Harden and Kyrie. But Kyrie is not trying to get his vaccine, y'all. And if Kyrie does not get the vaccine, he cannot play in home games, which is in New York.
A New York mandate, right?
Yeah, New York mandate. And he'll miss 40, you know what, I'm going to go on a limb. Not limb, but you know what. He's going to miss 40.
What's your math talking about?
43 home games.
43?
Damn. And the Knicks is plus two, so like 45, around 45 games that he's going to miss in New York. And he's going to miss, if he doesn't get vaccinated, and he misses all these games in
How
New York.
How many games again?
With Brooklyn, plus the two in New York, I say 45. Games. Yes. 45 total that he'll miss.
New York Knicks.
With the Knicks, plus two with the Knicks. He going to miss up to $14 million.
He's pulling out numbers like he just...
Well, right. He's amazing.
Maury's giving you accurate numbers right now.
I've been keeping up.
Don't challenge him yet.
So Kyrie can play the away games on whatever state or what city is not mandated to have a vaccine to play. But in New York, you gotta have a vaccine, bro, to be an employee or play for the team. So he'll miss
stadium, I believe.
Yeah, he'll miss $14 million if you don't play.
It's $15 million.
Woo!
I think you know it's 15.
It's more than 15, actually.
Double pay?
Let me take mine back.
No.
You said it.
You corrected George. You said 14.
Plus 15. Plus preseason is $17 million.
I was about to say 17.
Wait.
It's up to $17 million that he'll miss.
All right, you know, we'll drop pre-season. It. Me and Maury, we was paying attention to the same thing. It's okay. We'll drop it. Yeah. We'll keep it moving. Let's keep it going.
Now, my thing is, DeAndre, we hooped. I hooped. I'm a hooper. I beat anybody here 1-on-1. They say DeAndre, he's kind of good. But, DeAndre, he did shit. But,
I'm just out of shape.
Should Brooklyn Nets trade Kyrie Irving because of this non-vaccination?
Wait a minute, nigga. You a lie.
Wait.
Me and Brian both, nigga, was hoopers. You tripping. You said him and you and DeAndre the only hoopers on the table.
I played against Brian in high school 1 year when I played.
I played against Brian all the time in high school.
My freshman year when I got moved.
Never
up,
played against Murray.
For playoffs.
I mean, we all play pickup games. Oh, no.
Okay,
well, whatever. We'll get to that. But we'll get to that. What happened? What was that? What are you talking about?
Both of y'all niggas was wrong.
On what?
What you mean?
On the money?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, $15 million?
How much was it?
How much was it?
He was close. 15.6.
I said 15.
Plus preseason?
Did I say 15?
That's for the
season.
It's 41 games, too.
41 games.
Did I say 15?
So that's a good average, though.
Y'all should call me out.
Yeah.
No, I did call you out, and I said 15.
The original.
Yeah. That's a good average.
Y'all should call me out.
I said 15, right?
He called you out.
I said 15.
No, but then y'all resolved.
No, it's fine.
You still got wrong, though.
Yeah. I let it slide. I didn't know.
Call them out on that 45 number.
Continue.
Now, so
I stole my shot too.
Who's who taking the shot away?
He's a hooper, top shit. Okay.
No. This nigga said him and DeAndre is the only hoopers at the table.
That is a complete goddamn lie.
Exactly.
But
I don't think he said that. He said he'll beat anybody here 1-on-1.
That's also a complete goddamn lie. But we'll prove that later.
He said, except for DeAndre, because me and him are the only hoopers at the table.
I think he said because he's the one he hooped with DeAndre.
I hooped with DeAndre.
You're putting words in his mouth, Chris.
No, I'm the only one. I think he's the only one.
I know.
This nigga Maury said he was the blackest dude at Centennial, so.
I know that's what I heard.
That sounds a hood nigga, too.
That nigga said y'all was the only
Completely
hoopers
false.
At the table.
I played with some.
But should the Brooklyn Nets trade Kyrie to get rid of distraction, or should Kyrie just suck it up, get a vaccination, and get this ship that they're supposed to be getting this year?
That's a tough question.
That's a real tough question, because I feel his stance because of what history has shown us. So I can't really basically tell him
not to
do something that I wouldn't do or haven't done.
No grown man want to do something because I said so.
Right. Exactly. Like, but when it comes to Kyrie, everything is so much
more than basketball, right?
Exactly, because he thinks the earth is flat. He thinks
Illuminati, run the whole world and doing this and that.
I really don't have to say nothing.
Ancestry, but all the great points. He's majority of Indian tribes and of that nature.
Okay, that's fine. Why is he so conspiracy prone?
That's just his thought process, bro. That's just him.
How does that? I just don't understand.
That's just him. That's just who he is, bro. I don't know why, but that's just who he is.
I'll give you an answer to your question.
Please.
I don't think they should do either. I don't think he should be fired, or I don't think he should take the shot. Yeah. I think they should let it play out. And if he's if he's willing to miss that money, then I'd be willing to see how well or bad we'll do with
each game he misses. Each game he misses is over $350,000.
Well, it's not like the games he plays, he's not going to be vaccinated.
I said if he's willing to miss that money for the home games, then as the team, as the coach, let's just keep going then and see
You can't have him playing in the away games and home games. Because every question will be about Kyrie Irving.
Why not? The chemistry is off.
It's going to be off.
What if every game that Kyrie plays is excellent?
Yeah, you got as a
and
team.
He doesn't.
I mean, yeah,
and he doesn't get sick.
You got to make that decision.
I want to know.
One, but then the team loses.
Okay, but still, every game that he plays, 40. How many games are left over? Like 42.
If they go in 41,
they win all. Games, they win all of them with Kyrie.
They're still 40.
More away games 41. Than home games. So if they get 41 home games. They're going to lose, and then 45 away.
They're not going to lose 41 home games. They're going to win all of them. Probably damn near all of them. And then they're going to have Kyrie just primed and ready to go during away games. It's not going to be. And if Kyrie doesn't get sick, or if he does get sick and he's asymptomatic, like, it's just going to be a blow to the other side anyway.
Exactly.
So.
And the GM, you got to wait.
Someone else sick from him not being vaccinated.
This absolutism, it's dumb.
Best.
Don't drive people to that extreme.
Right.
Kyrie has made enough money.
How much he made?
He probably, I don't know.
I think Ben Simmons feels the same way.
He's able to weigh his decisions.
We gonna talk? Why do you think
based off how much money he got in his bank account?
While we got our opinions about Ben Simmons, why does he feel comfortable enough to just sit around and
Ben Simmons?
Fuck off.
He made a lot of money.
He's already got money.
I'm sure Kyrie
went
Ben Simmons is trash.
Neither here nor there. The point is, he fucking off too. Like, if he was about to be, like, impoverished, he that's wouldn't not, be acting like this.
Right. Yeah, exactly.
He would be probably one of the best players in the league right now.
Ben Simmons?
The hunger
Ben
Simmons.
Yeah.
I need a jump shot.
He's definitely like spoiled. That's what you would call it.
He is, yeah.
So that's my point. Never mind. I'm moving on.
I agree with the spoiled part.
I said last episode the nigga was throwing a hissy fit by not going to motherfucking
not doing your job.
Why he hasn't been going? But at the end of the day, they just saying these things to critique you and for you to get better.
Right.
So you can't take up the asshole. You can pay $30 million a fucking year.
You can work on your jump shot.
Apply summer.
Yeah.
To shoot
DeAndre,
the
apply this to Kyrie.
Right.
You have there's slingshots. There's so many things we use in high school.
It's a little different.
I agree. Different. If I'm Kyrie, I feel like I've made enough money. I got championship rings. I'm a Hall of Fame player. Is Kyrie a Hall of Fame player?
He has one ring.
But he has that milestone.
They call him the most skilled player ever
because he doesn't have a ring. This nigga's chasing the ring right now.
You guys are forgetting
he's only losing money.
He won with the Lakers.
No, don't start.
Shut up.
He won with the Lakers.
We already won the championship. It was bogus as fuck, but yeah, he technically got a ring.
He hasn't got that guarantee he would only play the away game because the NBA had to give him that exemption.
To play the games. Right.
But now, I think it's something that speaks to his willingness to take that risk.
Take your ass home. They have that right, too.
And he's like, okay.
All right, I'll go home.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay, but he's saying that if I get traded,
I'm done.
Retire.
That's he's going to retire. Yeah, right. That's what he said.
My thing is...
And he will retire.
I just wonder...
I feel like he will.
Yeah, he will.
He's in a position to.
I feel like Kyrie's the kind of person that does that math. Like, he's like, I've made like...
Kyrie, basketball is not his priority for Kyrie. Said,
like, what if he... He's enough money. Yeah.
Kyrie
like,
does
I've
not
made
need,
like 300
Kyrie
million.
Does not need basketball to be happy.
Yeah, that's not
his... He'll do whatever the fuck he want to do.
And if he's true to his code that he put out there, he's probably...
I respect that completely.
He's probably saved his money or made some good
moves. It's like, y'all expect me to be a puppet on your strings, fuck this sport.
Okay. But for Andrew Wiggins, Andrew Wiggins said he wanted to go get the vaccine, but now he got it because he said, you know what, I'm supposed to make this and that money.
That's a two different tax bracket.
Yeah.
Come on.
That's true.
Yeah, you're not Kyrie Irving.
But at the same time, they're making millions, though. They're making millions, though.
Was Ben Simmons one or two?
For what? For what?
Draft pick. Was he one or two? Wiggins was two, but he got
two. Was two.
He lost some of his money when he went to the Cavs.
Wiggins was one.
And then he went to the Timberwolves.
He never lived up to it.
And didn't live up to it, yeah.
He didn't live up to those contracts. He didn't live up to those.
Still got the same level of talent and can't live up to it.
Wiggins was one.
Andrew Wiggins was one.
Wiggins was one.
I think so. If I'm not mistaken.
I can't remember. I can't even call it.
I think he did, but you know, guaranteed one is $20 to $15 million contract,
right.
Guaranteed.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, but then he get traded or he got cut.
He got Golden State. He's good though.
It was the end of the
season.
But
some of those contracts are guaranteed because he's a rookie contract or whatnot. So I'm understand, but whatever he goes, it's state taxes.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
He was in Cleveland. He went to Minnesota. Now he's
now
in
Minnesota. Yeah.
California.
Taxes the most.
Gonna get the most. And what did he
stand in? What are you saying?
Just say up north.
He
better stay in Sacramento.
Anything after Stockton, you cannot find nothing under $2,000. Come on. A month.
Easy. At all.
Please. And if you do, it's in the hood. It's
You don't want to be
in the hood, nigga. You better 2,000.
You don't want to be there.
I remember.
Yeah. Andrew Wiggins said, you know what? Andrew Wiggins said, they made me get the vaccination. But at the same time, you did have a choice not to get it.
You had a choice.
You have a choice. At the end of the day, it's your choice.
They were conditioned.
But
you ain't trying to lose your livelihood.
Like, nigga, millions?
You ain't trying to lose your livelihood.
Exactly.
You ain't trying to lose that.
Remember?
Exactly, yeah.
I mean, can I ask something? Like, okay, so, I mean, yeah, we were talking about falling down to these principles, but, like, what's the basis of this resistance on a personal level to the point where when it got down to a personal decision, you were able to say, okay, I'll do it?
For Wiggins.
No.
For Kyrie?
For anybody. For anybody.
Well, for Wiggins,
for you. It came down to a personal what
career.
Yes. Okay.
Mm-hmm. I got no plan B, C, D, F, A, B, C, L, B, G, C, D. Well, I ain't got none of that shit.
But
this is what it is.
Your comfort and your livelihood was more important to you than being worried about some paranoia that may or may not be valid. That's my problem here. What I'm bringing up is, listen, I feel that your hesitation is valid in one way and invalid in another. Yeah, you feel the way you feel, and that's perfectly fine. But you can't sit here and ignore facts. Like, when you look at the numbers and everything, and you looking for bad stuff in the vaccine, you're going to find something.
You're going to find something, right?
On the whole, the numbers are good.
Right.
And also, I mean, when you know what the vaccine is meant for, it's not a cure. No. Nobody really calls it a fucking cure. It's called a vaccine.
It's called a cure.
Okay.
That's the problem.
Who says who called it a cure?
Let's change the word and call it an inoculation. This is just resistance to a... resistance to
inoculation.
Yeah, I never heard that. Use that in a sentence, will you, please? What's that mean?
Inoculated with a fucking vaccine that's supposed to help you fight the symptoms of COVID.
But I see what Brian's saying, though, for sure, though. I see what he's saying, though.
It'll knock you out.
Yeah, knock you out.
The paranoia is, I mean, it's warranted, but at some point, you gotta just really look into your bias and think to yourself, really, it's just a shot.
Okay,
wait. Everybody,
they didn't think that.
I'm not done.
So many years ago.
Everybody has their biases. Everybody has their own individuality. So for everybody, when it comes to this, however they believe or not believe as far as getting the vaccine, everybody should be allowed to exercise that belief. Or whatever, just on a, I'm human.
Unless you believe in science and you're putting other people at risk.
Let me finish.
Okay.
Because I'm not disagreeing with you, but I think what's being categorized, it's not necessarily more important
science
than versus your how you believe. I think it's coming down to a survival tactic because now you're being forced to face survival against standing on my beliefs. So it's not because it's not important or because it's not that important. It's because I know if I take this stance, knowing how much I believe in
survival against what now?
For survival.
Survival. Surviving what? What are you surviving?
No, but see, that's good. But that also goes back to what Brian said.
That's why I said I'm not disagreeing.
But that's why I said
I just want to know what you're trying to survive
comfort,
right now.
That man is in the word of comfort. He's comfortable with the way of life he's living. Yeah. And he's not going to change that for no fucking shot.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. So I'm speaking.
Not Kyrie Wiggins. Because Kyrie, he don't give a damn. Kyrie made enough money.
Right.
Yeah. Kyrie has Nike. He has shoes.
He's got movies out here and all that.
So what I'm saying is for Andrew, it may not be because it's not that important that he can't take the same stance.
Right.
It's that he's in a different position of survival.
Right.
Now, if
Andrew Wiggins would have been fine. He could have stood on his own principles.
Yeah, I think he would have been fine. Honestly, yeah, I think he would have been fine. Right?
He would have been better off than us.
He
didn't feel that way.
He didn't feel that way. The same way Moy didn't feel that
way. So subjectivity is everything. Moy could probably still
be fine, but the nigga just like said.
Is subjectivity everything?
Subjectivity is right on most players. You talk about an NBA player that barely got out of...
Nigga, we got to have a basis for something.
He jump and dunk. Literally. He didn't have no high test scores. He's one of those guys... I'm 6'9", I can dunk on you, and I can shoot three. Mm. Like, period. That's subjectivity is because...
Changed his whole life for that.
It changed him and his family's life. So if he gave that up just because of the shot, and I'm pretty sure it's the
people
that's telling him, like...
I can see that.
Just do it. We need this. It's general wealth in this.
And if on some instinctual level you feel like that's not right, you're not going to let somebody tell you you're wrong.
That's what his stance was.
Yeah. Okay.
And he said that. Wiggins said that. I hope someone is stronger than me to stand on their beliefs because I got a shot and I want a general wealth for my family. That was Wiggins' reason for getting a shot, for sure. So, I mean.
Yeah.
That was his sense.
So, on a deeper basis, like, he just believed in the vaccine.
I mean, I guess.
He got him and his family all vaccinated.
I don't think you can draw that conclusion from that. I don't think you can draw that conclusion. Because that's not
him and his family.
His family helped decide that for him. Yeah,
right?
Like, okay, help out. I'm fine. Right. Can you do it for the rest of the family? Yeah. Because you're the one with
the money, bro. You're the bad man.
I don't understand what he own out there or a clinic or whatever. His family could be working for him.
Now.
Maybe that's what's bringing the root of all the money in. Money's
root all evil.
Right. So what I'm saying is, I don't think you can draw the conclusion.
Well, I guess we'll find out in 15 years, like Maurice said.
The vaccine changed.
Right.
That's all I'm saying.
Did you hear me?
Yes, I did.
Yeah, I'm
talking about ears is big.
Now, is Kyrie gonna get the vaccine?
That was just for the microphone.
It don't seem like it.
It don't seem like
DeAndre is sharp though.
I heard that too.
They said they let him practice in Brooklyn with him, but he can't go to the game.
But that's some practices though. Not even all.
Yeah. Because
New York.
I'm not sweating Kyrie. He gonna hoop, man. He gonna be well rested.
It seems like
he's not gonna get sick either. He's not gonna get sick. Other people aren't going to get sick because they're vaccinated, and then we're all going to see.
I think we're all going to see that
people are being really stupid about this.
I thought he's doing this
because we going to see.
If his money get low, that's when it's going to show.
Yeah. Maybe
he's gonna be like, damn, I need to get it.
If he's living that kind of life,
you better buckle up.
We're gonna wrap it up. 20 minutes.
Buckle up, nigga.
Let's wrap it up.
100K a year. That's what you
is Kyrie
right
getting
now.
A shot? Let us know in the comments, man. He's gonna get a shot now, man. Let us know for sure.
And that only took 20 minutes. Frankly, I just came across a track that Kendrick and J. Cole collaborated on. It was a long track where they both kind of exchanged beats and did rhymes on each other's beats. I felt like it was an equal exchange. And when I dropped it, I realized, I was like, well, that'd be a good versus. It'd be nice to see maybe the best of Kendrick or your favorites of Kendrick versus the best of J. Cole or your favorites of J. Cole. So that's my premise. Is what do you guys think? What's your votes? Who's better, J. Cole or Kendrick?
Because we're going to do a whole
Who's better as a rapper or who's better as...
Listen, man.
Artist.
We're going to go artist. Track for track.
Qualify
right
however
here.
You want. Really.
I'm Team Cole.
I'm K-Dot all the way.
Kendrick, yeah.
I'm K-Dot. I've been K-Dot since high school.
I ain't been K-Dot that long, but I never had thought I would.
I think J. Cole shit might be more known, though.
But we know Lamar, too.
Mm.
I think the basketball thing fucked it up for now. I'm just playing.
Damn, you know what? You know what? I'ma go. Damn it! I'ma go. Cole on this. I'ma go J. Cole. Yeah.
Damn.
I'ma go J. Cole. I like Kendrick too, man. That's but I'ma.
And Brian?
I think J. Cole got more out there though.
I'ma go Cole too.
I'ma go. Nigga, man. We all California niggas.
You know
so
what?
You going with J. Cole?
I'm going J. Cole though.
Damn. So did four niggas just pick J. Cole?
No, they picked Kendrick.
They pick Kendrick.
Oh, y'all pick Kendrick? Okay, my
did
bad.
You pick
J. Cole? No, my bad. I'm just thinking. It's hard, man. I think it's Impact versus.
Yeah, I think the same thing.
Impact. Going song for song,
though.
No.
Impact, though.
It's nigga, Impact versus.
We going song for song. For song.
If it's Impact, it's gonna be Cole.
You a lie from the.
Nah.
That's what I'm about to say. If it's Impact, it's Kendrick.
Impact
if it's
J. Cole,
if it's volume, I think if it's volume, you got J. Cole because it's so high quality.
Or trying to get their life. At least you see niggas in LA trying to rap.
A nigga's been rapping long before.
If it's okay. Lamar, Impact, no. It might be Cole, bro.
I'm gonna give it to J. Cole. I've been listening to both of their shit lately, as like a person.
I like it. You gotta pick one.
I've listened to a lot of J. Cole. I've listened to a lot of Kendrick, but I've listened to a lot more J. Cole. He's just actually, if I could break it down,
he was an NBA pro, simple terms.
He's easier to listen to.
Okay.
J. Cole is easier. He's easier to listen to. You can listen to him in almost any situation.
J. Cole?
Yeah. With Kendrick, I mean, that's not always the case.
So it's three Coles versus two Kendricks.
Three versus two?
I don't believe that statement.
And I've been enjoying Kendrick. Like that was hard for me. Sorry, y'all.
Yeah, it is not easy.
Y'all qualifying all this with everything that don't matter. We just finna go song for song. And yeah. we're seeing how these verses go.
You're right. The verses determine.
J. Cole has never said anything that made me think about something too hard. He says things that made me want to think, but Kendrick has made things made me want to think.
There you go. That's the thing. J. Cole will say things.
Cole haven't said that to me.
He'll make you think, but most of the time he just says stuff you agree with.
Right. And that's it.
Yeah.
It's just stuff you agree with. Okay.
So that's fine. But sometimes Kendrick, like,
okay, to Pimp a Butterfly. What was that about?
Hell, I haven't listened to it in its entirety at all.
Like, to Pimp a Butterfly?
I don't know. I wouldn't know. It's we can't get into that. Different. We gotta get into this top five.
We do.
This is top 10.
Yeah, like, this is.
We have to get into
song.
It.
Pimp a Butterfly is my favorite piece.
Have you ever seen a rose growing concrete for me?
That's my favorite album of Kendrick's is Pimp a Butterfly. All right. Sure.
Drag this over.
Wasn't really a big fan of Good Kid, Mad City. I know this is a lot of people's favorite. Nah, wasn't my jam. Did not like Damn.
Yeah, Damn.
I've liked every single one of J. Cole's.
Damn was based on his. The titles were based on emotions. I thought that was fucking clever. And I listened to.
Cleverness aside, the songs didn't move me like that.
The songs themselves, actually, I mean, I don't know. You got to be into them. And that's the problem. If you're not into them, then it's not.
It's all preference, bro.
It's not objectively. That happens, but if
I like Kendrick.
If you want to like an album, you'll even listen to it after that first listen. And that first listen, it usually isn't a good listen, but you'll keep on listening, right?
Yeah, you gotta listen to it.
Check the mirror out.
I was about to set up the. I'm about to set it up right now. Okay.
But now you can't see it. You need to mirror it. Who will YG be good against?
G versus. That's why I need that.
YG versus who?
So we changing
beat. YG got bangers. Yeah. Nah, I don't say this.
It's too late.
Nipsey's songs are more.
Oh, his songs got way more substance for sure. Yeah.
Way more.
Oh, for sure. Yeah. I just couldn't think of another up there rapper.
Who would YG be good against?
The Game.
That's a good.
Wrong generation.
Who else would you go with from?
YG versus who?
Who else could you think of? That's not a West Coast rapper that you would put against him.
That's not a West Coast
rapper. Wiz Khalifa?
Nah,
YG is
different. Yeah,
different. Them, yeah, that's different vibe.
I would say
it's like him and Snoop in the same kind.
I wouldn't say Lil Baby. I would say somebody like
Lil Baby.
Hell no. 21 Savage.
Hell no.
Nigga, against
the trash ass nigga.
Against YG.
21 Savage is boo boo.
That nigga boo. All
right, y'all ready?
Boo Dookie.
That nigga hot garbage.
I have no idea what we're talking about right now.
You might as well say 6ix9ine, motherfucker.
Damn. It's all about to be cut out.
You have to say human versus Mozzie.
YG.
Y'all ready?
I thought Mozzie too, though. I thought Mozzie too.
Listen.
Yeah, but none of them was all about Mozzie.
That's
why I didn't say him. That's why I didn't say
21 Savage.
I know.
Yeah, I probably said that shit.
Listen. I said that.
I didn't want to say Mozzie.
Go ahead, Brian.
I feel you, but that's kind of what I was thinking.
Why she got a weird error?
An error? Where?
YG has a weird error.
Oh. Yeah, he does. He does.
He's his own thing.
He got our college and...
Yeah.
But it was
right after them early 2000 niggas, but before them, before this new generation.
Yeah.
Live right.
You're
not lying, bro.
Yeah, you're right about that. Yeah, you're right.
Not lying at all.
Yeah. Yeah, man.
Like, YG is the party. Him and DJ Mushmaze.
Man.
Party bangers.
Bangers.
Boy. 2 or 3, maybe even 4 or 5 years.
Bangers.
Hey, DJ Mushmaze, he go crazy.
Genius.
Yeah. Right, he's amazing. Yeah. He's a great producer.
Right.
Wow.
Anyway, J. Cole,
I was the only one that drunk my shot. You.
What's the only thing I like about J. Cole?
Oh, shit. Joe didn't take any shit either.
I said I'm the only one took mine.
Why'd you take it?
The only thing I like about J. Cole is that he used.
I thought we all was taking him.
Well, shit. Chris ain't took it. Hey, Chris ain't.
I thought we was waiting. He got that Nice Wonder sound, and I love Nice Wonder as a producer.
DJ Mustard?
No.
Who's this?
Oh, now.
Y'all ready?
Yeah, let's go.
Who's his first?
Restart it and let the people know what we do.
We got to bring in the subject, y'all. All y'all.
We did that.
We did it already.
Let them know that we about to play song for song.
Okay. And we're about to play song for song. I don't know, from top to bottom. Top 5 J. Cole, top 5 Kendrick. Just 5 songs.
Now, it's good.
We're going to see if our minds change.
I think it's a good ear test.
We got, 2 for Kendrick, 3 for Cole. Let's go.
And we're gonna have some Kendrick complainers in here. I already know.
Who's this right here?
This is J. Cole.
Okay, Lil Baby.
Cries the devil. Think you got a hold on me. Cries the devil.
That's my spirit.
That's a good song.
Is that trash?
It's not his top 5 for me. Yeah, it's not his top 5.
He's trying to be great. When did he start singing?
Major Drake vibes.
All these niggas sing.
Is singing a bad thing?
I don't think so.
If this is number one,
we just chose 5 songs.
They've been singing for like 3 albums, I feel like.
I've got one up every album.
You know what I mean? He's not.
As a rapper, I don't think he's hopping Kendrick.
You know what? I heard enough of that one.
Okay.
I didn't
think
that before.
Okay. Wow. All right.
Thinking of Drake.
I did not like that
song number one.
You didn't like it at all.
I didn't like that shit at all. I know. I didn't like it.
At least I wouldn't do that.
Nobody pray for me.
Not one of his top 5.
Pray for me.
Oh, come on, man. Okay, this one.
I'm going Kendrick on that one.
I'm gonna say
I didn't say it was his top 5, but it easily beats that last song, right?
It does.
Okay.
So that's one for Kendrick.
The beat alone.
In that match, Kendrick wins that one, right?
That's why I said all the qualifiers don't matter, because they're going song for song.
We'll move on. Kendrick, that go hard, bro.
We'll move on. It's just a banger. I didn't want to be in any particular order. This one, though, I might vote for.
This is Kel Cole.
Yeah. This one I might vote for. This is a good shit right here.
There are many ways to deal with this pain. Choose wisely.
Can I sing it again? Is that crowding me out again for y'all?
It does take a while to come in.
I might have made a mistake.
It does take a while to come in. Have you heard this song before? You heard
this song before? You said take a while? Okay, let it go.
Let the beat drop at least.
Okay, we'll do that. We'll do that.
A kick. One kick. Count it up. That's hot. Count it up. Nah. Yeah. Nah, don't play. That's hot. Don't hate.
Count it up. Count it. Okay, let it keep going though.
Count it up. It's also repetitive.
Yeah.
I don't hate it, but it is repetitive. Count it up. Mm-hmm. I know that it's difficult. I'm taking this paper, it's sort of habitual. I'm sorry, man. If you haven't heard these verses and listened to this song. Oh, really? Alright, what's the vote here?
You gotta play Kendrick.
Okay.
Not even his regular flow.
His regular flow.
So I'm about to say, when you change it up on your new album, I think that's legit.
Nah,
why not?
That's too.
Kanye did it. And won.
Everybody starts speaking that stuff with me. Go did. I ain't got time.
What about no? Kanye did it though. He went 808 and Heartbreaks and.
But people didn't pick that up until like 3 or 4 years later.
They was fucking with it before they was fucking with 50 shit.
I said I'll fuck with 808. It's not my shit.
Okay. All right. So that was number two by J. Cole, which
that's called what's called?
Which is a heavy vote, but this next one we all looking at it right now. I got loyalty. I think that's a banger, but
it's not for me.
No,
came in with it. I had a long ass intro. I'll tell you that.
It's still chorus. It's still chorus. It's beating chorus. But he goes in on the verse immediately. Yeah. I'm gonna vote J. Cole on this one.
Chris,
you vote what?
I'm voting on this. I'm on Kendrick on this one.
Okay. Y'all got Kendrick
hard.
Sherman, Kendrick.
I don't even like the song.
Biased.
Oh, okay, he rolling with it.
It's 2-0 Kendrick, bro, right now.
No, it's 1-1.
I was vibing.
Sherman said Cole.
You said Cole on the left?
I chose Humble one. So one. I didn't pick DNA. I picked J. Cole. I think Kendrick still won.
Play, okay, so it's 1-1. Play the next. You just play.
You want to play next Kendrick? Kendrick. Okay, well, I like this one.
Yeah, it's a banger.
All my life I had to fight.
This
is hard, bro.
That's a banger. Pimp Butterfly is my shit.
But this is why it's unbiased, because it's not like our first day.
It's just five tracks. That's a banger, though.
My son likes this track.
That's a banger. That's going to be hard to
generational
beat.
Right.
That's
here.
Hard to beat.
Like, I don't look for, but when it come on, I just be like,
this is track right here, bro. You going to the fair times, but you know what? We going to be all right.
You feel me?
We going to be all right. I recognize you looking at me for the pay cut. Cadence. But I'm going to be looking at you from the face down. You know what?
In the body.
I do like this cadence.
Going on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, we all up in it. Okay, moving on. All right, track number three, J. Cole.
We gonna be all right.
Yeah. Hey, this is one of my favorites.
The mood is different, though, on this.
People don't listen to J. Cole, though, man.
This is a banger, though.
This is some good shit.
Is
right
J. Cole
here.
More like Drake?
But see what you just said, even though he wouldn't be my pick, this is the more vibe I'm used to him giving me.
The mood different on this one.
But you know what this song is about, though. Right? It's some good shit, though.
It's a whole concept.
I just think
right?
It's really good. And we're really well put together.
Thought out.
I think the flows were not. I mean, what you know.
The flows is there.
Yeah. Okay.
All these qualifiers, nigga.
Wait, let me look back. What did we just listen to? Because that's hard.
Yeah, that's all right. Hard to beat.
Yeah, it's hard to beat.
That's hard to beat. Whatever you
and
play.
And it's not even to say this about.
Not neighbors. Neighbors not gonna take that one.
That's not gonna take. All right.
Y'all want to move on?
Yeah. I think that's.
I got Kendrick.
What's the score as it stands?
2-1.
3 tracks in. 2-1. 2-1. Kendrick.
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 Kendrick. Okay. All right.
This is a tough one too.
Oh man, I'm sorry, y'all. I picked these. No, you better
play
shut
it,
up.
Play it.
Man, you
know.
A hater.
Some people know. You ain't fooling this. That bass line.
Nigga, this is all DJ Quick type vibes.
He don't fuck with Quick like that.
Oh damn.
He don't fuck with Quick like that.
What the hell?
Oh, right. He ain't Cali for real. He ain't Cali. He a Bay Area nigga. He a Bay.
it's cool.
What kind of work this give me all, right? This give me all click vibes, nigga.
Oh, yeah. Nigga, if you from California, you better vote for this track.
That baseline. That baseline, yeah.
Anyway, okay. That's track number four for Kendrick. The power that be.
I don't like that at all.
You can smell it when you're walking down the street.
Oh, yes, you can.
I don't like that. I don't like that at all, bro.
This?
I don't like it.
Mori don't got no funk in his soul.
Like it.
He don't got no funk in his soul.
I'm a guest rapper.
No funk.
I don't like it, bro. It's whatever.
It's whatever.
I'm a two-man sale.
A two-man sale?
Okay. I don't know what I would have picked for J. Cole on this
one. But again, another build up on the intro.
I wouldn't have picked, 40 songs I wouldn't have picked, to be real with you.
Nah, it ain't got shit on the Kanye. Nigga, we was doing the Kanye thing, nigga. We listened to this album, bro. Oh, yeah. The intros on that, we was like, nigga.
Mm-hmm. Hollywood Cole.
I like the beat better already.
Then the other one?
Just
a tad bit.
I mean, just on writing.
I was feeling that.
Oh, the other one was Cali
that,
strong,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, that
I mean, right. Since we Cali, I'm going to go to
the flows. The flows on this one is hot.
A long build-up. Long build-up.
Wait, we don't have a vote on this one yet, right?
This ain't happening either.
I'm voting.
Build-up.
Yeah, a lot of build-up. This is going against J. Cole strong.
I remember that one kind of song we listened to?
Right there,
it was like, damn it, he's going to drop.
And then, he sings for like.
Yeah, it's Kunta. It's Kunta.
It's Kunta. It's a good track, but it's 5 minutes long.
I think we got what we need to know now, right?
Whoa, but we got to play the last two tracks.
We can play them, but we know what we need to know.
So is that a point for Kendrick?
I'll go Kendrick on the last one.
On this right
here? Yeah, I'll go Kendrick.
And he didn't like either one of those songs. All right.
Yeah, it's Cole Drake.
Let's honorable mention.
It's Cole Drake.
I want to hear
J. Cole Drake. Do it sound similar?
Yeah, you want to hear like Workout Plan or Workout Plan.
Where's Workout at?
No, I understand what you're saying, though.
Yeah,
right.
Not like that, but there were other ones. There were other ones that I would have wanted to hear, personally, for J. Cole.
That shit go hard. I like that shit. That's Cole's good shit.
ATM, if you would have played Kevin's Heart, maybe. I would have even said Kevin's Heart would have been on there. Well, let's play these last two.
At least got one.
Play last two.
So this is Kendrick. Grew on Me, this track.
New Kung Fu Kitty.
That was one of his better ones on there.
Y'all know what happens on Earth it. Stays on Earth.
Mm. This is Cole right here.
Here we go.
No, this is Kendrick.
I don't give a fuck. Mm. I don't give a fuck. I'm willing to die for this shit. I done cried for this shit.
From the get-go.
He do get to the business. I ain't playing around with you. Get these bars, my nigga.
This nigga is going off. Me and Chris was talking earlier. I was like, I don't think you've been listening to Kendrick.
Oh, I'm over here. That's what rap niggas better know.
Now tell me that wasn't a banger.
Right. Come on.
I don't even know what this is. What's Landon Snakes? Okay. All right. Chris guaranteeing me a banger. Because
man, y'all can play Swim Pools by Kendrick.
Fuck that song.
What?
You all the way.
Section 80, bro. I'm telling you.
Swim Pools.
I've listened to Section 80. My favorite shit is Don't Blow My High on Section 80. That's my favorite shit.
Bro, that whole album.
Don't Blow My High is when
Miles,
oh
no.
My God.
Miles lived me when he knocked that.
Landed.
It was Dot and Nipsey only.
Last J. Cole track.
Bitch, don't kill my vibe.
Let's be respectful. Last J. Cole track.
I'm telling you, that's the album.
Bitch, don't kill my vibe.
Okay. You know what? It's a banger. Yeah, let me put it on. This one ain't got a like. Got everything else had a like on it. If you notice, on my list except this one. It's a banger.
Probably the most neutral list that we
can. And he start flowing from the get-go.
He didn't get after it.
Okay.
Exactly. You see that?
This is what you want, right? This is J. Cole, right? This is what you want.
That's J. Cole. He's live musician to the
A lot of bounce on that. A lot of bounce on that.
Rip the hell out of that tape. I give him that.
I like this.
This is hot. This is shit right here.
Ain't no winner and I do the most.
I'm the president, you the coach. You said, yeah, I'm the coach.
Honestly, I was about to say you could have picked like three other tracks and wiped up Kendrick with them.
Right?
I think you might have wiped up Kendrick with J. Cole if you picked three other tracks.
Some hot tracks.
They were okay. Practice the Devil's all right. There was a few that I would put over Get Off My Dick. There was one I would put over that. I think I would put one over Neighbors and that one. These two, I love. ATM, Atlanta, the Snake.
All singles off of them.
All great. I'm being picky.
I just went one off every album. I just grabbed one.
But off the ear test, yeah, and we had some bias.
Oh, heavy bias over there.
All right, but.
Heavy bias.
But it stands.
It stands.
What's up?
We lost this two tracks ago.
Right, let me pour some.
Y'all niggas.
This nigga DeAndre
was Maury, like, I ain't picking a J. Cole song.
And Brian was pre-pumped.
Maury was quite impartial, so we taking these shots.
Them songs, that it didn't represent him well.
Look at him. Maury managed to utilize
that. I think those lists were probably the most neutral lists that we could come up with.
I know that's not a good word.
Give me some socks.
What?
You know what? Damn, I ain't know what actually happened before I searched over now.
I need a song.
I need a song too. You pick Kendrick. You good?
What the hell? Nah, you still got this song though.
Say what now? I don't know, man. I just grab whatever the fuck is on.
I don't know what I'm drinking.
This is how I go down, man. This is why I lose. All right.
They just had me over the car in college.
Oh yeah, me too, man. I was I can give you some stories about that.
I still fuck with J. Cole.
But we could just move on with this continuity.
I listen to him more than Kendrick.
Yeah, but for the sake of our verses,
but
Kendrick got the harder flows.
I lost his verses, so salute.
Salute.
See,
continuity.
Losers. No, it's fun.
I think that was my second shot this whole time, though. So, haha.
That's for my essay, homies.
And we out here.
All right, y'all. It's been another episode of You a Lie.
You a Lie.
We talked about J. Cole and
what's his name now?
J. Cole and Kendrick Lamar.
No, is that right?
Versus. We talked about Kyrie Irving and the vaccination. Is he going to get it or not? He's losing a lot of money if you don't take that shit.
Yeah, what else we
but
talk about,
that's
though?
Your thing, though. But we talked about Dave Chappelle.
Okay, all right.
And his so-called last stand-up on the Netflix,
For a while.
He said he lay low after that, man. So, I mean, we talked about them three topics, though. But you can catch us at 805NT. We got our own.
Yeah, man, we got right
our
own
website. We got our fucking iTunes cracking. We got Instagram. Mm-hmm.
805NT.com.
Facebook.
Yeah.
Shit with us. We got Buzzsprout, man. We're on all social media platforms.
We got the merch.
Y'all.
Yeah,
we got the merch. We got the air. Oh, shit. I ain't got my goddamn sweater, man. God damn it.
They got
It's hot. It's going to be a while before we're wearing sweaters.
Go ahead. It's hot. It's still in California. It's still hot, though. But you can definitely catch our merch on LYNT.
Yeah.
Man, purchase good shit, man. It's good material. Good, everything's good on that motherfucker, man. Definitely support us. Keep downloading, subscribing, liking, man.
Yeah.
And we got a special guest in the house, man. Hey. Smooth, man. Came through all this, bro.
Welcome. Much needed opinion.
Weekend, man. Chris's birthday this weekend, man. How are you gonna be, bro? What you gonna do?
Hey, we gonna take it anyway. We gonna take a birthday shot.
Yeah,
we'll take a
birthday shot for Chris for sure, man.
It's freaking dark. I ain't with that.
That's right. Yeah.
But we gonna take a birthday shot for Chris in this outro.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
So brother.
I also want to give a shout out to all black men.
Grab a cup.
Okay, he getting real.
So hard to even driving our car. Yes. To even go to the grocery store. I just want to give a shout out to all black men that doing their thing. Taking care of their families, taking care of their kids, do what the fuck they gotta do.
Do what they gotta do.
Nobody acknowledges them. So yeah, I appreciate that.
Exactly, yo.
Man, y'all can catch my handle, man. The Snapchat, Josh_Will15. The Snapchat, IG, J_Will R6. I used to ride bikes, you know. I used to pop wheels, you know what I'm saying? I'll be out there doing my shit.
Okay.
But,
nigga barking the mic.
Chris, man, where can you find you at, bro?
Hey, if you don't know, you can find me on C-Boy Designs on Instagram. That's where I'm at. Hit me up for all your graphic needs. I should post more shit, but the stuff I got there, you can see what I'm doing.
That's some good shit.
Hit me up in DM. Talk prices. We can talk how I can service you. You know, I'm excited to the work that I'm doing right now. I appreciate y'all that hit me up for this service and help me stay afloat out in these streets, if you understand me.
The streets.
So that's C-Boy Designs. Holla at
me. Man, Brian, man, what can you find you at, brother?
You can find me. Troll me at BDaniel24.
Trolling!
On Twitter. Nobody's trolled me yet, but you know.
It's coming up. It takes time, right? Listen, bro.
I give you a hot take. Yeah, right. Somebody somewhere is going to get me.
Somebody. Yeah, man,
but if you don't do that, you can find me at your game name, Blame.
Y'all know what I'm
not really.
You know, I'm on Facebook, I'm on Twitter, I'm on Snapchat, I'm on Instagram. No, because I've been saying, fuck Facebook, I've been staying off their platform like that. I've been more on IG and Twitter.
They've
been tripping.
They got whistleblowing.
Hey, I thought my phone was tripping when they went down, but I went to Twitter and found out the truth. See, fuck Facebook. They misinformation. You want the truth? Go to Twitter.
Trump. Get out of here.
Right. But yeah. Holla at me. Holla at your boy. All
right, man. My nigga Smooth in the building.
Smooth, man.
That's your boy, DJ E.
Mixmajor on Snapchat. You can also find me as MixmajorDre323 on Instagram. So hit me if you need DJ services, engineer services. So holla at me.
You know all about that.
Hey,
that's our brother too. This nigga know his shit.
I want to say a pleasant surprise, bro. You slide through. He blamed me on the okie doke. He texted me today like, man, what you doing for your birthday?
I forgot he was coming.
You know what?
You know what?
On the okie doke. But okay.
You gotta make it up.
All this came because of Ariel, bro.
She made this happen, bro.
Earlier today, I was like, Chris, just don't go anywhere, okay?
I was like, Pop's trying to go. He's like, I don't like that.
And I was like, I know. Just don't do it.
It's my birthday. He's trying to get some birthday. Happy birthday, Papa Smurf.
We had a good time, for sure. But otherwise, man, it's been another episode of You Alive, man.
You Alive!
It's his birthday, man. I appreciate everyone that's in the building, man. I love y'all. I met Chris. Cousin Sherman, bro, in Vegas. So, this nigga been rocking here, though. 10 plus years, bro.
Yes, sir. 10 plus years, Brian, same shit, bro.
Man, Smooth Man, the same shit, bro. I met all y'all niggas off of Sherman alone, bro.
It's a hell of a ride, right?
I appreciate y'all niggas, man. And more rides to come, though, for sure.
Hey, so we appreciate y'all for rocking with us and for y'all celebrating this, our brother Chris'
happy birthday, Chris. Thank you. I want to say it on the camera before we go.
Like, this is the time that I feel like the most like myself. So I appreciate y'all, brothers, for allowing me to come on here and act a fool with y'all.
Agreed.
Doing our goddamn thing on the You Alive podcast.
You Alive!
You feel me? Hey, and I appreciate y'all for watching us. Yeah, thank y'all. And we out this bitch.
Salute.